Hi guys, welcome to Techie Ocean. In this tutorial, we'll see how to implement data filtering using REST API. So let's begin. So here in this tutorial, we have two APIs. First one is jsonplaceholder.typecode.com/albumns. So this is the API of albumns. You can see we have user ID, ID and title. So you can see we have user ID, ID of the album and title of the album. So we have a second API here, and in the second API you can see this is the API of photos for that album. So from the previous API we are just going to pass the ID of the album and get all the photos in that album. You can see here the album ID is 4, for example, and rest of the fields are of photos. So we are going to implement a small data filtering example in which we are going to have a select list which we are going to bind this API, and in the data grid we are going to bind the results using the second API. That is, we are going to pass the album ID from the first API and we are going to filter it using the second API and show the results. We are going to create two classes for both the APIs. So you can see here in the classes folder we have two files, albumns.ts and photos.ts. These files have classes which have all the fields which are given by the REST API. So you can see here the albums class have user ID, ID and title. Which we are getting here. Similarly, for the second API, that is photos API, have album ID, ID, title, URL and thumbnail URL. So these all fields are there in photos.ts file. So you can see here in the photos.ts file, we have all those fields from the second API. So here for calling the REST API, we already have a service named as free API service. You can see it here in the services folder, free API service.ts. So you can see we have this service as injectable. We have imported the HTTP client and HTTP params from Angular, common HTTP. We have injected our HTTP client class because this is important for making HTTP requests. And we have imported our free API service in our app.module.ts, that is here. You can see here we have imported the free API service and we have also provided it in the provider section here so that it is available in app.component for injecting. Similarly, we are importing the HTTP client module. HTTP client module is important for making any HTTP calls. So we are importing the HTTP client module here, and in the service we are going to inject it here. And now we'll create a method for calling the first API. So let's create a method getAlbums which is of type observable. Here we are going to call our first API. That is this API for binding the result in a select list. So as you can see here, we have simply injected our HTTP client here. So here we are just going to write return this dot and use our injected HTTP client which is used here dot HTTP client dot the get method and the path of our API, that is albums API. So you can see here we are writing return this dot HTTP client dot get method. This is the inbuilt method of the HTTP client and we are passing the URL of the API, that is albums API. Now we have declared this method in our free API service. So let's go to our app.component for invoking this service and binding it to the select list. That is our dropdown. So let's go to our app.component.ts. Here we have already imported the free API service and we have injected our free API service here using dependency injection. Import our albums and photos classes, that is these classes, which is the fields which we have written from the REST APIs here. Now here we are just going to declare a object list of albums of type array of albums. That is, you can see here we are going to create an array of type albums here, because we have to get the result of API and populate in this array. And in the ng-on init, we are simply going to write this dot free API service dot get albums, which is there in our free API service, dot subscribe. After that, we are going to write data, and here we are going to bind the result which we are getting from the API to this object. That is this dot list of albums equal to data. So now let's create a select list, that is a drop down, and bind this data. So let's go to app.component.html. A div and some CSS. We are going to simply write a select list and options. So let's bind the data to this list. So in the options, we'll just populate this list of albums. So here we are just going to write ng for loop let album of list of albums. And the value field of this list will be album.id. That is this. And the text will be title. And in the display, that is the text, we are going to simply write interpolation, that is album.title in double braces. So we are filling the select list. The value field is ID and display is title. So let's run this. You can see here the title is being displayed here. You can see all the titles and the value field is ID. Now let's create a variable for populating the selected item and then passing the album ID to the second API for data filtering. Let's go to app.component.ts. Here we are going to define a variable album selected as number. This is nothing but the selected album ID from the select list. So let's go to app.component.html. Here in the select, we are just going to write ng model equal to album selected. So whenever we are selecting or changing the value of the select list or the dropdown, that particular ID will be populated in this album selected model. And for using this ng model, we have to import this forms model from Angular forms. This is important. Without this, ng model won't work. So coming back here, so just for demo purpose, we are just going to write the selected album ID is album selected. When I select anything, you can see the selected item is, the selected ID is 6. when I select another value, you can see the selected ID is 11, that is the album ID. So we are getting the album IDs on the change event of this dropdown. Now we are going to pass this ID to the other API, that is this API, and we are going to get the photos belonging to that particular album ID. So let's go back to our free API service. Here we are going to create the method for our second API. So we are going to just write a method getPhotos for selected album by parameter. We are going to send the selected album ID a string, and which is of type observable. And you can see here that in the second API, album ID is the parameter. So we are going to declare the parameter using httpparams. So here we are already imported the httpparams from Angular Common HTTP. Here we are going to simply write let param1 equal to new httpparams dot set, and here we are just going to write the parameter name, that is album ID, and the selected album ID value which is we are sending. So this album ID is nothing but this parameter name. So after this, we are just going to simply write return this dot http client dot get and the URL of our photos API, comma, bracket, and as we know, we are going to send the parameter as album ID. We are just going to write params semicolon and this param1 variable. So let's go to app.component.ts, and here we'll just define a variable list of photos of type photos array. That is this class. Now this is to catch the result of our second API. Now let's go to the app.component.html. And here we'll just give a change event to our select list. So we'll just write ng model change equal to on album selected. So this event will be fired whenever we are changing the value of our select list. That is, whenever our model named as album selected is changed, then this event is fired. So let's define this event on album selected. So let's go to the app.component.ts. Here I'm just going to write on album selected, and we are going to pass the selected album ID here. Here I'm just going to write this dot free API service dot get photos for selected album by parameter, what we have defined here. And it is accepting the selected album ID, which we are sending here. That is whatever value which is selected in the select list dot subscribe the data, and we are just going to write this dot list of photos equal to data. So whatever filtered data we are going to get back, we are just populating it into the list of photos. So let's go to our app.component.html for displaying the filtered data in the data grid. So we'll just write a header get photos for album, and we'll just have a table. table. We'll just have heading, that is ID, album ID, title, and thumbnail. And here we are just going to write ng for loop let photos of list of photos, whatever result we are getting back from our photos API we are displaying here. And here we are just going to display all the columns, photo.id, photo.album ID, photo.title, and the image thumbnail URL. So here this thumbnail URL is an URL of the image, that's why we have used a image element here, and the source is thumbnail URL. So let's run this. So when I select album ID as 6, you can see here that the respective photos records are being populated here from the second API. Similarly, when I select change the value of the select list, that is album ID 11, and then the respective records of album ID 11 is displayed. So thus in this tutorial we have seen how to implement data filter using REST API. So that's it guys. Thanks for watching. Kindly subscribe, like, or share.